Hi students, in previous session we have already discussed some basics of functions. Today we will see parameter passing techniques. Okay, so see, what is parameter? So parameters are nothing but inputs given by the user to the functions. So in previous program we have already seen that your function call is somewhere inside main function, isn't it? And your function definition is written outside the main function. So if a user wants to give input to the functions, then you have to create a reference which is called function definition, which pass the input given by user to the function definitions. So function call does pass the your inputs to function definitions. So we need a reference. Reference are called function call is used to pass the input given by user to function definition. So parameters. So parameters can be passed from your calling function or function call, you can say, to function definition can be done by two methods. So from two methods. So there are two methods for parameter passing. First one is call by value. Second one is call by reference. Okay, there are two types of parameter passing techniques. So we'll see one by one with the example. Okay. See, here you will find two concepts. One is actual argument, another is formal argument. Arguments means you have seen already in previous example, we are using like this. Values present inside any function called arguments. Okay, So actual arguments. Arguments present inside the curling function. Curling function. Curling function or function called. Arguments arguments present inside the curling function are the actual arguments, and arguments present inside your function definition called formal arguments. Arguments present function definition. Okay. So whenever we are declaring any variable, so some memory is allocated. Okay, so memory allocated for actual argument is always different from the memory allocated for formal arguments. Okay, remember this. So to understand the call by value, we will see one example. Write a C program to swap two number using call by value. Okay. What means write a program, okay, to swap two numbers using call by value. I'm taking a variable k and here only I am initializing with the value 50. Okay. Another variable m with 45. See, here is the complete program for swap to number using color value. See, here this is the function declaration. This is your function call or calling function. Okay, and this is your calling function is always written inside main function. This is your main function because compiler starts execution from this main function and ends in main function only. So to access, see here we have written function definition outside main function. To access this function definition, you have to use a function call, which is called function, which is also called a reference. Okay, this is your function definition. Function definition. See, I have assigned a variable k with 50. Whenever we are declaring any variable, immediately some memory is allocated. So here we have declared k and m two variable. Immediately it will allocate some memory. Means suppose some memory is allocated with the address 100, suppose it is for k, and we have initialized with 50, and another variable we have declared, that is m, and again we have initialized with 45, and this address also allocated with some base address. Okay, see, next part happens. Immediately next line is return swap km. This is nothing but calling function. Whenever hits this calling function, immediately your cursor will move to the function definition. Wherever be the function definition is written, immediately your cursor will be moved. Now operation will be done in this function definition. See, we have declared a temp variable, and already I have told, see, memory allocated for your actual argument is different from the memory allocated for your formal arguments. See, these two are called actual argument, and A and B are called formal arguments. Okay. See what I did again. Here, value of M, K, and M are copied to the corresponding formal arguments. Means now, temp is created with suppose 200 address, then A is created with 202, and V is created. Okay, see what happens. So now A is initialized with 50, B is initialized with 45. See what happens. Now temp is with empty value, no value. So see, now in next line is written A temp equal to A, means whatever the value present in A is copied to or stored to temp. So now temp is having value 50. Okay, again next line, see, A equal to B means whatever value present in B is stored in A. Okay, so A value is now changed to 45. Similarly, see, A value is stored in B. So, time value, what is the time value? 50. 50 is stored in B. 45. See, what will be output now? Printf, K value will be 50, time value will be 45. Here, after swapping, A value is 45 and B value is 50. So we have swapped, means change A, this value to this value. But see, the difference is in call by value, whatever value is copied from your calling function or to function definition, but the modifications, whatever change, is not reflected back in this actual parameters or actual arguments. Okay. So this is all about your call by value. Now we will see call by reference. Call by reference. Reference means address. While in call by value, while passing, we pass the values, but in call by reference, we will pass address of a variable. Okay. So to use call by reference, you have to know two operator. One is ampersand, is address of operator, asterisk is used to access the value present in that variable. Asterisk is used to access the value contained in that address or that location. Okay, so to understand, we will see one example. Same program, write a program to swap to number using call by reference. Okay. Here we are using asterisk because what I said, in call by reference we are passing the reference. Okay, we are passing the reference. To hold that reference we need a pointer. Okay, That's why we are using asterisk. This is your function declaration. We have declared, see, this is the complete program. Here we have declared variable k and m, and we have initialized with 50 and 45. K 50, and suppose 102 with 45 m. This is your function call. Okay, see, this is your address of operator. See, if I ask what is k, k means k's value 50. If I am asking address of k, means what is the address of this variable, what is it? So address of this variable is 100. Okay, similarly address of m is 102. Okay, so in a call by reference we are passing, means see, now the value of address of a is 100 and this value is 200. Okay, this is your calling function. And we are passing argument as a address. Okay, we are passing address. Immediately control switch to
the function definition. See, this is pointer declaration. Int a is pointer declaration, means a is a pointer which holds the addresses of integer type. Okay, a is a pointer which holds the addresses of the integer type. Okay, so what it means here, I am passing value to here, value is copied to corresponding arguments. Okay, here 200, here 102 is passed. So a is here not a simple variable, it is a pointer variable. Okay, so what it means, a is a variable which holds 100, means a's value is 100 whose address is something different, suppose 200. So a is a pointer variable which holds the addresses of some integer variable, means 100 whose address is 100. This case address is 100, means a is holding the address of this k. Okay, similarly b so it is pointing to m. Okay, so again now we have created one variable, particular one variable with m. So what happens? See, this is your address of operator, and asterisk is used to find the value contained in that address. So it means value contained in this address. So value contained in 100, asterisk a means value contained in a. Okay, value containing in this address, 100 address. So what is the value contained in this address? 50, means now 50 will be copied to tab. 50 will be copied to tab. Again similarly, asterisk b means value containing in the memory location or address 102. See, in address 102, what is the value present? 45. So 45 is copied to this location. Similarly, now value present in temp is 50 is copied to this location. Sorry. Okay, because here formal argument are acting as an alias. Okay, now you see the value print in k and m. Again, see here the value of this is what? 45, and value of this is 50. After completion of this function definition, the cursor will move to from where it came. So return to this curly function. After curly